गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, टुडे इज 11th जुलाई 2021। आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग। पास्ट फ्यू डेज आई वॉज वेरी बिजी, बट आई डिडंट वॉन्ट टू मिस द ब्लूम्स इन माई गार्डन। दैट्स वाई एवरी डे आई मेड श्योर दैट आई विल टेक पिक्चर्स वट एवर इज ब्लूमिंग, एंड आई ट्राई टू अपलोड स्मॉल स्मॉल वीडियोज adding all the pictures of each day, so in that way I can relate in which month, which week they bloomed, so that I can keep track if I am continuing my YouTube every year, I mean in upcoming years, so I can relate like that, and also I can learn lot of things seeing the pictures where I did a mistake and what I need to improve. So thinking that I tried my best, I just did not get time to record videos, but today I thought I have some time, so let me do it, and so I'm here, and I'm standing near my big leaf hydrangea, which is this is the third year of it. It's like one here and one there, one is there, that one, so they both were pink. They had pink blooms when I bought, so that is kind of my center here in the bigger circle. I make that as center, so towards my house, so in front of that, that is the new done climbing rose. See, now all the blooms are gone, so they may set up a new batch of blooms to bloom in September or August, but right now they don't have any blooms. They are done one phase, so that is behind that autumn jade sedum, and this is a new hibiscus which I planted in last October, so few months you can say, and it has a lot of buds, and that is a phlox. So, and this is tiger lily. Last year it bloomed very well, last year I planted, so this will be its second year of bloom. I'll show you when it blooms, and this is the hydrangea, big leaf hydrangea. So it was, it had blooms, pink blooms when I bought, but among pink and blue I like the blue. It's not that I don't like pink, just I have lot of pink pink blooming plants in the garden, so right now I prefer if I can add more blue color as compared to pink. So I like the bloom, I like the color. I had no idea this is so big. If it is, you are able to notice in the video or not, they are so big. See my hand, I have a middle sized palm, and then see, they are so big. Those sticks are still there because when I did not have fence, I had individually given a deer net around this plant to save it, so I just didn't remove those sticks, and it's still there. Close to it, this is a white white rose I planted this year. It bloomed also, and there are few zinnia here and there. I showed many seeds, but somehow this much left here. And this is a Russian sage, so it looks like lavender, but it is not lavender, it is Russian sage, and they are very good in our area. I mean, they are hardy, they survive the winter, and they come each year and they bloom, and they tolerate the heat in the summer, so in that way it is a very good plant. Then this is the Bodleia or butterfly plant. I forgot the exact variety name of this color, but I had shared a lot of pictures. It bloomed very pretty. Just yesterday I removed some dried flowers, but I'm supposed to remove more, but just I did this much only. It was evening last night. And this is my color guard yucca. This is 3 years old, and in its third year it bloomed, so I have three, like you can see, that was the third one, this is second, and that was the first one. So this one bloomed, and now it is all gone, but I enjoyed it. It has cream color flowers, and people who has these kind of plants, for them it is very common, but for me it is very new. And this plant I like it because even if you don't water, still they survive the summer. And so they are very good plant. They don't need any extra care and they survive and they bloom. And their blooms are very pretty. I came to the innermost circle. So this is purple profusion or something, explosion, its variety name. Veronica, pink Veronica, purple Veronica I mean. So this is the status. The iris blooms are done. And this is one Beckman's Golden Arbory Vita. So according to me, it is growing well. See, it's just to look green in the winter, I added this here. This one, and this is the boxwood. So it's just in the winter, other may not be visible, they will die, I mean the leaves. But this dogwood and boxwood, sorry, I said dogwood, this is boxwood. So this boxwood and this, they are evergreen. So in winter also we can see them green. So thinking something green at the center I will see, and if I want some Christmas light, thinking that I had planted, and they look good. So here I came to show you this. See, gladiolus, they are annual, they are not hardy. Each year you need to plant. Last year I planted in the border of that third circle and they bloomed very well. I did not give lot of compost, but they bloomed very well. I liked them, that's why I saved all the bulbs. And this time I planted here in the second circle. So see this, it yesterday the only one bloomed, and now I don't know if I mentioned this is 7 a.m. in the morning, 65 degree, very nice temperature. So around 11 o'clock it may rain, so because of that I thought, okay, let me record whatever I can before the rain starts. So my gladiolus and lilies, they are all in bloom. So this is the white gladiolus, see, those are some cosmos. And see this lily, I have shared the pictures yesterday. So when I planted the gladiolus, I did not have extra space. These are all I think lot of grass or some, so I did not find space to put pumpkin seed. So I thought, okay, let me put just seeds. If it germinates, I will shift them somewhere else, thinking that I showed some pumpkin seeds while putting the bulb of the gladiolus. So wherever there is a gladiolus, you may find some pumpkin plant. And you can see the flowers. Now they are every day from the last week, every day there are a lot of blooms. So this is the white one, then this is the pink one. If I can go to the back and show you, let me show you. See, this is that same lily, and this is one sorry, I'm trying to bring the name, delphinium. Yes, one delphinium. It was very tiny, it was like this tiny when I planted last year, and this year it is this. And this plant, this is a cornflower. Last year also I was not able to see the full petals because the some insects, they are eating the petals. And this year too, those are some orange marigold. So these are my yellow iris. And see, this is the I told you, a big hibiscus. I planted here, one exactly on the opposite mirror spot. So both are red but little different in look. And here some zinnia. And see this, I had asked you in earlier videos, I want to know what kind of plant is this. So finally it is a different variety of Rudbeckia, of different variety. See, so that's why I take a lot of pictures, because I'm not sure every year it will bloom or not, because you don't know what happens each year and how it is. So I'm not a professional, I don't take care very perfectly that it will come out every year. I don't have that much knowledge, so I just keep exploring. And in that way, every year the garden will be different. So there are so many blooms and so many varieties. See, here it is dark, this is dark, and this is like in the center the maroon colors are line. Here the maroon colors are more fuller in the center. Here only like a button in the center, black button. That's why maybe they call it black eye Sujan also. See, this is another variety which is the 50% of the petals are completely maroon. So there are different variety. And this is one of my friend gifted me last year I planted. This is a Shasta Daisy. Let me go back to the center so that I can show you other gladiolus which are blooming. I came back to the white. So now see, this is white. This is, I showed you, pink and little bit design in the center. This is some Japanese beetles are in the garden and they are eating all the rose buds, rose blooms. So see, this is again pumpkin. So I tried a rose of that orange marigold. That's why I had like, I think at least more than 2 months it is, I sowed the seeds. So here another gladiolus about to bloom. Some zinnia, cosmos. That is zinnia. This is cosmos. More lily. And see, there are pumpkin too. See my pumpkin. Though I don't like pumpkin. I like the branches. I showed the seeds to eat the branches and the leaves. So these are, I had shared a lot of pictures, just I will quickly give you. See this? This is another variety. It started blooming yesterday. But when they start each year, they add, they open 2-3 extra flowers. Again pumpkin. See the blooms. Then see the white. And behind those kind of tick seed, once I asked you what kind of plant is this, when in the winter it was completely green, that plant, that is the plant. So it is a type of tick seed. And in the rain, in the wind, the branches are so tall that they are on the ground right now. This is another lily. So this lily is a rose of lily that I had 20 bulbs I planted last year. And it was written 75 days of blooming. So that means the bloom may continue 75 days altogether. And this is the purple gladiolus. And see, orange marigold. More cosmos. It looks like it will bloom white color. Pumpkin. Wherever there is a gladiolus, there is pumpkin. And this is the first gladiolus it bloomed, so see, I think it is already 1 week, so the branch got bent and you can see few old flower, and then see, I'm holding it to show you because it bent. I had shared the pictures of it many times. Again pumpkin. This is one type of it was written pineapple sage. I planted it assuming it has very pretty red color bloom. So let's see, once it blooms I will share with you. And here there is yellow gladiolus. Yellow gladiolus. I came closer to this tick seed. There are so many blooms. So initially I did not know they need support and they will be like this on the ground, but they are. And there are so many plants, they need support, that and I didn't have that much time. So these are few zinnias which are on blooming. So this is the blackberry. I could not make it stand and give support. I already took twice. I harvested twice. This is Asiatic lily I planted last year near the Paliban lilac. These are few Cleome seedlings. Here I wanted to show you this. This is the vanilla strawberry hydrangea. So they almost started blooming. So now they will be cream color. Slowly they change into pink and then in the fall into burgundy. So right now this is the status. And close to it I planted, this is new, Karishma its name, the variety, rose variety. But again the Japanese beetle already reached, so the blooms, they do look damaged, but today it is not hot, that's why you can see the water particles in each petal. And this is the second hydrangea. Sorry, the first big leaf hydrangea. In the second there are so much big bloom, but here it is only this tiny and a single one. There are no more. So see, though it is close to the other one, still how they decide about the spot. And see, this is zebra grass. I cannot show you everything now, it will take long time, but slowly I will show you. So this is my Honeycrisp apple. I think only four I see. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I see only four. Three there, one there. Only four. But I am not expecting, because it is only 1 year old. Last year I planted, so I am not expecting a lot of fruits. At least 3 years we need to give time to the plant just to be settled in the root and be happy with the spot we planted and let it survive only. And see, day before yesterday we had a storm and see the result. It's a huge tree. And then I came close to this weeping cherry tree. This is the invincible Limetta hydrangea. So it is a smaller height as compared to other hydrangea, which are like 6-8 feet of these big blooming hydrangea. So this is a dwarf version, and according to me, if I'm not wrong, it will stay the cream color all the season. Let's see, because this is the first year of its blooming. And then behind it is the sweet summer hydrangea. Last year also it bloomed. Now the inner two, they already bloomed, and the rest, they are little slower. So in that way we can see the bloom for a longer time. I just wanted to show you this week how the status is, because in 2-3 weeks they will be in completely full bloom. I mean, all the buds will be opened. And then finally I want to show you the grapevine. See the status. I don't know if you all are able to see these or not. There are so many grapes, but I feel they are bending. They are bending, and we are new, so we did not give. So far, we did not give a stronger support, and they are about to touch the ground. And I think they will be spoiled if they touch the ground. So I'm thinking how to do. But see, it is so tempting to see. I feel so good when I see these. But I don't know whether we are able to eat or not, because you don't know about, there is a rabbit every day in the garden. Lot of squirrels, lot of birds, so I don't know. But right now they look very interesting. They make me very happy. Can you see? I don't know, maybe there are 500 at least, I think. So that's it for today. I just wanted to show you a little bit the updates on the grapes and my garden, and I will keep recording regularly now. So I'll stop it here. Thank you for watching.